Good morning. This is Kelley Hobart from Alpaca Direct, and I'm here. I have some Christmas stockings, and I'm having so much fun with them. And I also have a Christmas stocking that Meg, our dear person who takes care of our a lot of marketing for us, and she's a wonderful knitter, and she made this beautiful stocking. I have to show it to you. Isn't it beautiful? It's very lightly blocked. It's not completely finished yet. I just love it. Meg has done such a great job with this stocking. And it is used, we used Encore to make it with. So here it is. See both sides of it? Beautiful. Like I said, it still needs some ends woven in and maybe a little more blocking. I just very lightly blocked it, but it's so beautiful. Making Christmas stockings for gifts is totally awesome. You can make something personal, something that each person would like. Maybe you add squirrels or deer for the hunting enthusiast, or the sky's the limit. So let me show you the pattern that she used. And don't forget, as we're going along, to let us know what you're working on and post comments in the comment section so we can learn from you too. And don't forget to write the name of the patterns and the designer so that we can take a look at those too. This is Meg's pattern, and it's the one that she used to make her stocking, and it's by Faye Kennington. And I think Meg laminated hers. Isn't that awesome? You can make like 30 different stockings with this one pattern. See how it has different sides to it? All different kinds of options with it. So you can make, see what the front page looks like. Can you see it? Can you see it, Jim? Yeah. So it's totally wonderful pattern. And if I'm not mistaken, this is the same pattern that I've had in my, I've actually purchased and not done yet. So I'm excited to do it. And she used an Afterthought Heel. This here is an Afterthought Heel. And I thought today we would, there like that. So I thought today we would talk about how to pick up stitches for an Afterthought Heel. And Meg had a great idea. Wait till you hear the idea that she had for picking up stitches for an Afterthought Heel. I mean, it's so simple. We should have all thought about it, but we didn't. So I'm going to share it with you a little later on so that you can enjoy it. This is another one of the stockings that she is knitting. And if you see right here, she has scrap yarn placed right where the heel is going to be. Do you see where she placed her scrap yarn? So what you do when you do an Afterthought Heel, you knit a big long tube, but you just have scrap yarn sitting here waiting for you to come back and do the heel later. So you can just do all your color work and then you come back and do the heel. And so doing an Afterthought Heel is allows you to knit that big tube of knitting, and it's a great way to do it. Now, here's what her yarns look like, the Encore. If you haven't used it before, it's a wool acrylic blend, and it's perfect for stockings. Her stockings feel wonderful. They're fantastic. Now, if you look at mine, I have mine's made out of vintage chunky, and I'm not done with them. And you can see down here that I'm making trees. Do you see the trees? I'm putting beads on my tree. And the pattern didn't actually, well, it looks as if they have you come back later and add some ornaments if you want to, but I did mine as I went. And you can see I just put, I decorated my tree with little black dots where I wanted the beads to go. And then I'm putting them in. So I'm almost done with my tree. You can see I've marked off each round as I went around. And
why don't you show me again, because you said it was kind of fast.
No, oh, this one? Yeah. Sure. So here it is. I'm just knitting along. Isn't that fantastic? It's going to be a great Christmas stocking. And I had the just added those little beads, and I'll tell you what kind of beads I used and what numbers they were and where I bought them and how I put them on in just a little bit here. Now, let's see. Every week we have a contest, and you guys remember that this last week we had the baby Alpaca Grande tweed, and I think the winner was the white color, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that was the winning yarn for this last week. And for this week, I did a couple skeins of vintage chunky because that's what I made my stocking out of, the vintage chunky. And the vintage chunky pattern is called Blitzen, Dasher, and Comet stockings. And let me see if I can show you the front of it. And you can find this on our website. It has three different stockings, and you can see here It's for beginning stocking knitting. This is a great way to learn because you're using chunky weight yarn, and I didn't cast on, it doesn't require very many stitches, so it's really a quick knit. I think I did this much in basically one day of knitting. So it's, yeah, so this was that much knitting in one day. So you guys can do that too. It's if you need a quick gift. And don't forget, when I cast on, because there's ribbing at the top and we don't want the ribbing to suck in, I used a needle that was one size larger. Actually, I might have used a needle that was two sizes larger, but you can see there's no, that ribbing stays out really nice. And so I'm totally excited about it. And then when I'm done, see how I went to Joanne's and I bought some flannel. And that you just want a fabric that's not stretchy. And I like the flannel because the flannel is nice and soft, and I'm all about nice and soft. But you see how nicely these are going to go?
Hey, Kelly, one thing you just mentioned, because it's so hard to find the red and greens because everyone's out.
Uh-huh.
This was, someone said they liked your colors. So this is like an alternative. So if they can't find the red and greens and whites. You know,
right. I think a lot of times nowadays, our traditional red and green, a lot of people are going with all different colors. And so, like with mine, here are my four colors that I used. Let's see if I can grab all fours. Do you see my four colors that I used? So those are my colors that I used. And we don't have a ton of stock in right now because we keep selling out of this yarn faster than we can get it in. Right now, everyone is in a big hurry. And I think there's a ton of people out there that are trying to do blankets right before Christmas. Oh, my goodness gracious.
Well, mention that. Because when we get Barocco, it sells in like a day or two, right? The Barocco, we get as much as we can get, and then it's gone.
Oh, my gosh. The Vintage Chunky and the Ultra Alpaca Chunky, Ultra Alpaca Light, Vintage DK, Vintage Worsted, Vintage Chunky. Those yarns by Barocco are very quick sellers for us because they're excellent quality yarns, and the price point's really good. Although I think this Encore is also a really good value. So Plymouth Encore is a good quality yarn, especially if you're going to use four or six different colors. It's a good price point, and you can do quite a few stockings because I think this yarn has 200 yards. So not quite as much yardage as I was thinking, but it still has a lot of yardage. And I've used these before, and it seems like it goes on forever and ever. So you get a lot of bang for your buck. Again, my little beads, I just added my little beads to it, and it's an alternative to embellishing your tree after you're all done knitting the project. So you go ahead and put the beads in there as you go, and then it is knit right in place, and it's kind of cool. There are a couple of things when you're doing the beads that are, that you need to know about. And so do you mind if I just take a minute, Jim, and go over that with him right now?
So, okay. Well, one question was for Meg, just to let her know that she's the one who's posting, so they know who she is.
Right.
She's the one who's posting.
Yeah, Meg is the one that responds to your posts while I'm talking to you. And she is fantastic. And she's the one that did this stacking. And she's the one that has these beautifully laminated. Have you ever seen a pattern so nicely maintained? My goodness, that's a lot of effort. I don't know if it came this way or not, but that is pretty cool. And the sky's the limit as for you can do all different designs. You choose your design. So they're kind of like one-of-a-kind stockings.
So they can let Meg know that they like
it. Yes. You guys, don't forget to tell Meg how nice it was for her to share it with us. And you see they did an I-cord bind off, and then the hanger is a little I-cord too. Isn't that cool? Yeah. And I don't know if she's going to have time to line them this year, but she said she would like to line them. Maybe might need to get done next year because she's doing quite a few stockings. So she has her work cut out for her.
Oh, what's the contest for this week?
This week was two skeins of the Vintage Chunky.
So how did they work?
This one is kind of a lilac color, and this one's kind of taupey. And this is Vintage Chunky, the same yarn that I used for my stocking. And so you guys choose which color you think we should send out next week. And the winner, all they have to do when they win is contact customer service at Alpaca Direct.
And gray then, or what's it?
I don't know. This is kind of a tan or a taupe color, and this one is kind of a lilac-y color. I really like this one because it has, I don't know, it's pretty.
Lilac or taupe?
Yeah. Yeah. So you guys choose, and we'll send that out next week. So, and you guys know how to enter to get the prize, and that is to post comments in the comment section. Of course, if you're working on a beautiful project, we want to know all about it because, you know, then I'll probably be knitting it next week. I get sucked down rabbit holes faster than I don't know what. But it's, yeah, I really enjoy knitting. So seeing your projects really gets me motivated. And I always tell myself, I need to knit faster. So anyway, let's take 1 second and take a look at our Afterthought Heel. And if you guys are not familiar with it, I'm going to move these beads out of the way here. And I have my little tiny sample that I have here, and I just cast on 20 stitches. And I started out by taking this thread in here and placing a lifeline. So if my heel, let me show you. So when you do your Afterthought Heel, half of your stockings have this extra strand of yarn in it, right? It's just scrap yarn that's sitting there waiting for you to come back later, and you're going to be taking the stitches on either side and creating both sides of your heel. You create this side of your heel and this side of your heel at the same time while you're working. And that's what makes it so you can knit your whole tube and then come back later and create that beautiful heel. So here I've done a lifeline. This is Meg's. I can't take credit for this because Meg came up with, she said she saw it somewhere, and she's been doing it for a lot of her Afterthought Heels from since she's seen it online. But so I have taken my little darning needle and threaded all that, this pink little strand of, you need to use a strand of yarn that is not fuzzy, because you want it to go through all the stitches. And then I kind of did a little slip knot so it doesn't accidentally fall out before I get back to pick up those stitches for doing the Afterthought Heel. So here I am. If you do that Afterthought Heel, I've completed a round of work, and I have my working yarn coming out of the back needle there. And simply to place that scrap yarn in place so that you can do that, come back later, you just knit across the round, knit across halfway, just to the end where this scrap yarn is, or excuse me, this little lifeline is the same half the stitches. So I knit all the way across here. And then what you simply do, whoops, I barely gave myself enough yarn. That is not ideal, but I can take it and move it over eventually. Okay, so then what you would do is you would come back here. Come back and place all those scrap yarn stitches back on your left-hand needle, because you're going to knit it again with your working yarn. And then your scrap yarn is placed. Isn't that cool? That's pretty easy. And then you can come back and do that Afterthought Heel. So what I would do now is I pick up my working yarn that I have, and I knit that again. Okay? And think of that different color yarn as your, like a bookmark, where you're going to come back later and work the heel. But picking up those stitches can be kind of a bear. But having Meg show us how to put a lifeline on both sides of where the scrap yarn is. So then what I would do is I've knit across here, and then I find that other pink strand of yarn of kind of, it's kind of a thread. And I place that strand on my darning needle, and all I do is once again I place a lifeline. Okay, and what this does is it allows you to have a perfect pickup for your Afterthought Heel, and then you don't have to try and figure out, have I picked up the stitches properly, is it going to look funny when it's done? No, it's going to look perfect, because guess what? You did a perfect placement of your lifeline, so you know exactly where to pick up your stitches, because you're just going to take a smaller needle. When I pick up stitches for the Afterthought Heel, or any time that I'm picking up stitches, I like to use a smaller needle because it allows me to get into the stitch easier. And then I would knit off of that smaller needle with the needle that I'm working with. And it's just an easier way for me to get underneath those stitches and not struggle so much. It makes it so much easier if you have a smaller needle when you go to pick up those stitches for the afterthought heel. So here I am. So there is that. Okay. And then now, do you see what we have? We have a lifeline on either side of our scrap yarn. So when we go to pick up those stitches, we simply take our working needle and we follow that strand of yarn, and it perfectly picks up the stitches for you. So you don't have to try and figure out where to pick them up. So it looks perfect. I think that's so ingenious. And when Meg told me that yesterday, it's like, oh my word, I need to share that with the whole world, because that'll make everyone better at picking up their stitches. Because, hey, that takes all the thinking out of it. All you have to do is place those little lifelines and go on your very merry way knitting. And then I would just go ahead and pick up here, and I'm just knitting my stocking again. Of course, I have to scoochie my work up a little bit, and I'll show you one. So now I have completed the round. I have placed scrap yarn for the afterthought heel, and I have placed two lifelines, one on either side of the scrap yarn, so that I can have a perfect pickup when I go to do the heel. See? So scrap yarn below, scrap yarn above, and scrap yarn for, it's actually like a thread, more like thread than the yarn. But isn't that cool? Then you'll have a perfect pickup. All you have to do is take your smaller needle and just pick up that right-hand leg all the way along, and you'll have a perfect pickup. Isn't that cool? I was so glad when Meg told me about that, just in time to help you guys learn. So now I wanted to look at one more thing that I was working on, and this is my beads. Now, first of all, Jim, can you hand me my notes over there, sweetie? I'm sorry. I just need my notes here, because on these notes, I wanted to show you a couple things. Where is it? Let's see. For how to add your beads for your Christmas tree, what you need. It says what size of bead you need. First, you need 1.5 millimeter crochet hook for your 2-0 beads, which fit over chunky weight yarn. Let me tell you what. When I did mine, I went to Joann's and bought my beads. Now, these beads that are in this baggie are ones that did not fit in my crochet hook. But I'm hanging on to them anyway, because if I run short on my beads, which I'm almost out of beads, then I could possibly put these or make the holes a little bit wider somehow. I don't know how. But anyway, I was going to hang on to them. So here I am. Here's my tube that my beads came in. And you could see that I bought them at Joann's, and they're check beads, they're glass beads, and they're 2-0. And this was actually pretty inexpensive. It was like under $4 for these beads. And it comes in a handy little container. Note, word of the wise, always buy extra. Don't short yourself on beads or anything, or yarn for that matter, because when you're knitting a project and you run short, it's kind of hard to finish the project if you don't have enough yarn to do it. And I see people every day do that, right, Jim? Oh, yeah. They accidentally don't buy enough yarn. And then they call us up and say, we need this dye lot. And sometimes they get really, really lucky. And sometimes they don't. Right, Jim? Mm-hmm. And so just for all of you out there who are knitting, buy enough yarn for your project and you will be a... Yeah. See my beads? How I put them on there? So on my, I'm looking at my bead chart. So I had one knit stitch. And I'm looking at this very last row here. One knit stitch, a bead, two knit stitches, a bead, and two knit stitches. So I'm ready for a bead. And when you do, I'm going to take some of these beads. When I'm looking at my beads, I like to try and find the ones that have a big hole, bigger. So I'm always looking for the little, and I always test it with my hook to see if it goes through there. And that one was a little bit sticky. In other words, a little bit small. That one doesn't even go in. I'm getting to the very end of my beads, so my beads aren't.
You're a good bead selector.
Yeah, I just stick it in there. Some people use a littler dish. I just use this glass because it's clear, and it was in my cupboard. And you know how I am. I like to use what I own. So when you go to put a bead in, some people will just thread the bead right on to this stitch. But because I want my bead on the next stitch that's being made, all I do is I reach through and grab myself a loop. So reach through and grab yourself a loop. And then you get your bead back on your hook. Do you see how small my hook is? It barely has a hook on there. And then you have to take your working yarn and kind of, you make that hook come up toward you. And then if you don't get the whole strand, see how you just pull it through like that. Isn't that awesome? It's that simple to do a bead. And then when I go to put it on my needle, I want to make sure that this strand of yarn is on in front, so my stitch is mounted correctly. Also, another thing to keep in mind when you're knitting putting your beads on, watch this stitch right here, because sometimes that stitch can get a little bit loose. And so you want it to be not too tight, but you want it to be the right gauge, not too loose either. And then you would take that off and that bead is already done and ready to go. So that is that. Yeah. Isn't that cool? So then I would go ahead and knit the last two stitches, and then my other ones are in white. And I want my tree to stand out, so I'm holding my tree in my tree color in my left hand when I'm knitting these. And then let's see if we can do this one more time. Okay. So we have two whites here. And when you go to knit where the beads are, you kind of have to scooch the bead out of the way, but it all works good. So we have two whites, and then I do a green, and then I'm ready for another bead. So let me just scooch it forward with that needle. Now I'm going to find me another bead that's going to behave. I think that one's a good one. That'll work. I think it'll work. Okay, and I hold it tight like a noose around the crochet hook so it goes through. See? And then I just pull it. There is another way that you can put beads on, and that is threading all your beads on first and then knitting the project. But that means that you have to keep scooching the beads along as you're knitting. And if you accidentally miscount, then you either have to do the rest of the beads this way, or you have to break the yarn to get the beads on if you haven't given yourself enough beads. So that is one of my beads. And then let's do that one more time. I have my, okay. And then we do a couple more. And then we reach through and grab ourselves a strand of yarn and find us a bead that will behave. That one might be good. And see, put that noose right around its neck. Thread it right through, and that one, I need to turn it there, and then I can pull that off the needle, tighten this puppy dog up, and see, now I have a couple beads on there, so I'm almost completely done, and that's how easy it is to put beads and knit them in as you go. Aren't they cute? It looks like little Christmas ornaments. I love it. I was looking at all different things. I kind of wanted to get silver ones from the jewelry section, but okay, it was going to be probably about $25 for the beads. And I'm like, the beads are going to cost as much as the yarn. And not only that, those silver beads are made out of a material that's heavy. And I'm going, what if it pulls my stitches down and my stocking gets really heavy?
Little Christmas balls.
Yeah, I thought it was good. I really like these beads. And I had asked Meg before I went to go shopping for my beads because of COVID and everything that's going on. It's like, where is the best place that they might have a decent supply of beads? Because, you know, it used to be before COVID, everyone had a fairly decent supply of beads. And then COVID hit. And so Meg said, Joann's, they have a really good supply. And you can also get the coupon codes from them too. Of course, I have a new phone, so I wasn't able to get the coupon codes because I'm still learning how to use it. I'm like, darn, I don't get to use my coupon code because I don't know how to get to Google and make it work. I said, darn, shucks. I wish I had my husband with me because he fixes all things computers for me. I just say, here, do this for me. I want to do that. Yeah. Someday I'll have to just break down and learn how to use the computer as well as I know how to knit, and then I'll be in good standing. But until then, I have to fumble through it. All right. Oh, yes. This is our knit club. Surprise inside. It should be out in the mail today.
No,
so
tomorrow.
Oh, tomorrow?
Yeah.
Oh, in the mail tomorrow. Yes. So if you're not part of the knit club, we learn something new every month. We're working on new skills, and I'm trying to get you guys so you get out of your box and try something new.
We have that gift option. Yeah. You might mention that because it's not on the website, the $99 for 3 months.
Yes. Jim just came up with this great thing so that you guys can put in your cart a $99 kit that gives your loved one 3 months supply of Knit Club, right?
And it's not reoccurring. Yes.
Reoccurring. It's just if you want to give a gift to someone and you want them to learn a little something for a few months, it makes a great gift idea. They can get some new skills under their belt and have fun too and use lovely yarns. Win, win, win. So let's look and see. I haven't looked to see who our winner is today. So we said that this color was the winning color. Let's see if I can find the name of the winner for this last week's prize. Oh, Laura Miller. Yay! You won some baby alpaca grande tweed by Plymouth. This is 100% baby alpaca yarn, and it makes great hats and lots of other things. So, Laura, all you have to do is get in touch with us, and we can ship this out in the mail to you. Again, Laura Miller, you are the winner. Yay! You get some baby alpaca grande tweed.
There's a request to vote on yes. The other one too.
Again. Don't forget, you guys, don't forget to vote on this one for next week. It's a vintage chunky, and it's in the taupe color or lilac. Whichever one you guys think we should send in the mail, that's the one we will send, right? So this next week, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be talking about how to line your stockings because I bought this lovely flannel to line the stockings. And so see how it matches? I thought it would be nice in either color. I want to do more than one stocking, so I bought two different colorways, and I'll see which one works the best. I was interested in seeing what it looks like when you block it and how, you know, what it looks like on the inside. So stay tuned for this next Tuesday, and we'll be talking about that. And I hope you guys have a great week. You guys stay nice and warm. If you guys are cold, don't forget to check out our socks too, because they're selling quickly, very quickly. And so if you have cold feet and you don't knit socks of your own, you should look at our Alpaca Direct socks because they're made from alpaca and wool. And they're warm. I'm wearing them right now. They keep me nice and warm. You know, if your feet are warm, your hands are warm too.
Your body's warm.
Yes, yes. It's so totally fantastic. So you guys have a great week, and I will see you next.